Now, this method is actually employed to practically determine the focal length of converging lenses. So, displacement method, this method, as I said, is used to determine the focal length of a converging lens. Now, what is the concept involved and what exactly is being done to find the focal length? For this, what we do is we keep the position of object fixed and we keep the position of a screen on which the lens will form an image of the object. The position of the screen is also kept fixed. So, what I will do first is I will consider this is screen which will be called the image plane. This is fixed and this is object plane which again will be kept fixed. We take the distance between the object plane and the image plane as capital D, which is known to us, right? Now, what we do is we will take two different positions of the lens so that an image is obtained on the screen for a given object. So, if I place the object, say this be the object, and if this is the first position of the lens for which an image is formed on the screen. So, this is position 1, I will write it as 1. This is first position of the lens. The lens can be moved. Now, considering a ray through C to locate the image, we can now say that this will be the image for position 1 of the lens. Got it? So, this is first position of the lens for which an image is obtained on the screen. Now, what we will do is we will move the lens, keeping the object and image plane fixed, such that again the lens gives an image, a sharp image on the screen for this particular object. So, I will redraw the object, same object, and now I will be moving the lens to a new position. Say this is the second position of the lens, I am marking it as position 2. Such that again an image on the screen is obtained, I2, for this object. So, for two different positions of the lens, we get two different images on the same screen. Now, what I will do over here is, if I take the height of the object to be HO, the height of the object is HO, In the first case, the height of the image obtained, this is HI1, and in the second case, the image has an height, has a height HI2. All the heights are obviously considered above or below the optical axis. So this is the case. Now let for the first position of lens, the object distance was of magnitude x. So the magnitude of the image distance would be how much? Yes, d minus x. By principle of reversibility, we can say that if object is placed here and image is formed here, so if the positions are interchanged, that means if object was placed here, the image would have formed here for the same lens. Now, that means that if object distance from the lens is d minus x, the image distance would be x. Got it? I am repeating it once again. If object is at x distance from the lens, the image is formed at d minus x. So by principle of reversibility, if I would have placed an object over here, then its image would be formed here for the same lens. That means if object distance was d minus x, the image distance would be x. So what I can say clearly is that the second object distance, that is for the second position, will clearly will be d minus x, and the second image distance will clearly be x. This is what we can conclude by principle of reversibility. Now, the final thing, as I said, that you have got two different positions of the lens. So these two positions would be separated by small amount, small d. So we have got two different values, capital D and small d, which can be known. What is small d over here? Small d and capital D. This is distance between object and image, and small d separation between the two positions of the lens. Got it? So these are known to us, capital D and small d. They are known, or we can measure them. Now, what all can we conclude from here? Let's see. First of all, small d and capital D can easily be related. How? If you see from this diagram, small d plus x will be equal to capital D minus x. So first of all, I will say from here, small d minus x, sorry, small d plus x is equal to capital D minus x. That means we got the object position x as d minus small d by 2. That means if you want to achieve these cases, that means image of an object, then the object should be placed at what distance? If the separation is capital D and the separation between the lenses is small d, lens positions, then this x is will be equal to d minus small d by 2. We got the object distance, right? Now, if this is the case, then what will be the value of d minus x? So therefore, d minus x can be written as d plus d by 2. By simple calculation, you can see this. I hope you don't have any problem in this. Fine. Now, if I use the lens formula for first position. So for position 1, of the lens, simply using one by v minus 1 by u is equals to 1 by f, what I can say is v, what is v? It is on the positive side, so d minus x u is on the negative side, minus x. Focal length for a converging lens is positive, obviously. If I put the values of d minus x and minus x, so what I get, 1 by d minus x becomes 2 times d plus d, plus 1 by x becomes 2 times d minus d, which is equals to 1 by f. So from here, 1 by f can be written as, taking the LCM, d squared minus small d squared, and what we get above, d plus small d plus d minus small d, so 2d, and this becomes 4d. So from here, the focal length of the lens can be written as d square minus small d square divided by 4 times capital D. So if we know the separation between the object plane and the image plane, that is capital D, and if we know the separation between the two lens positions for which the sharp image was obtained, then focal length is d square minus small d square by 4d. So this is how we obtain displacement focal length of a converging lens using displacement method. I hope this relation is clear to all of you. You can see this relation. Fine. Now, there is one more important observation and a shortcut or important result, whatever you can think it of as. That is, if we write the values of magnification produced in the two lens positions, what are we going to get? Let's see. For image 1, I1, fine, the magnification, if I write the value of magnification, M1, so M1 is height of image 1 upon HO, and obviously image 1 is inverted, so I will write minus sign, HO is positive, this will be equal to what? This can be written as F by F plus U, fine, F by F plus U. Or you can also write it as V by U. Fine. Now, what is the value of V and U in case of first position? In first position, as you can see, the value of V is positive d minus x and U is minus x. So if I put these values over here, what I can say, in place of V, write d minus x, and in place of U, write minus x. This is our first equation. And for image I2, you can write M2 is equals to, again the second image is also inverted, to minus HI2 upon HO. This will be equal to V by U. What is V for second image? Well, for second image, the value of V is x and value of U is minus of d minus x. So I will write here x divided by minus of d minus x. Now if you compare these two results or simply multiply them, what I can say from here is 1 multiplied by 2 gives what? HI2 by HO square is equals to, let's see, d minus x gets cancelled out, x gets cancelled out, minus minus sign gets cancelled out. That means a very important result is obtained over here, that is, the height of the object is simply the geometric mean of the heights of the two images formed. Got it? Height of image 1 and height of image 2, if we take their geometric means, you get the height of the object. And what else? The magnifications produced, M1, M2, their product is equal to what? Their product, as you see, is equal to 1 the product of the two magnifications is equal to 1. So three important results are obtained. One is for the focal length of the converging lens, that is capital D square minus small d square by 4d, if you look at this diagram. And the second result is the height of image 1 and height of image 2, if we take their geometric mean, that equals the height of the object. And the magnifications produced in these two positions of the lenses, their product will be equal to 1. That means the magnifications will simply be the reciprocals of each other. Got it? So please note it down.